Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about Scilab. Scilab is a numerical computation software that anybody can freely download. Scilab is called as an open source software because we can download anywhere and we can run this application anywhere or any kind of platforms. So there are here some of the platforms which are available to you. Those are like Windows, Linux, Mac, OS. So here on every platform you can easily download and you can easily run this application. To download this application, we need to follow this address called as www.scilab.org. If you click on that, you can be downloading on that and you have all the notes or the or whatever you want, the information regarding your Scilab, everything will be available on this website. Here there are some silent features of your Scilab, like Scilab can do. Scilab can make any type of calculations. It seems like your calculator type of thing. See, whatever you give, you just need to give with the command, then all type of calculations will be done here. And we can write the programs, and after writing the programs, we can edit the programs also here. And even we can do the graphics. So graphics for displaying different type of graphics. If you are doing your graph plotting, if you are doing your plotting, in that we need like graphics, like how your estimation will be and how your if you are preparing a house and we are making a blueprint of that particular house, and we can see that blueprint with the help of a graphic. So in that also it will be helpful. Scilab will be helpful to you. And one more thing is like image processing also. We can use this Scilab. So today we are going to discuss some of the functions of your Scilab. That one of the function is called as statistical functions. Here there are few statistical functions like mean, median, sum, geometric mean, harmonic mean, standard deviation, variance, quartile, minimum and maximum. So first one is like mean. Everyone, you know, I guess, how to do the mean. This is nothing but average of all the vectors is called as mean. Here I have taken an example from your application called as Scilab, and even have taken example like A equals to 25, 38, 45, 80 and 60. So what is a mean? Means it will add all the values and it will be divided with the 5. Why? Because 5 means here there are how many elements here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it will add 25, 38, 45, 80 and 60 and divided by 5. So you'll be getting this answer, that is called as mean. Next one is median. Median is nothing but it is called as a mid value, because whatever the vector you are giving in your you are taking as an example, whether it is in descending order or in the ascending order, but it will take or it will consider only the mid value. So I have given you an example here. Same example I have taken here also. See, this is in already in ascending order. If your vector is not in the ascending order, or no problem if it is in ascending order or it is in descending order, but it will choose as a middle value. How many elements are that will check, and it will take the mid value. So that is called as median. And for the median, we use a command called as median. Median we will use. Next one is sum. Everyone, you know what sum will do. And this is the command which we use, sum here. Then it's nothing but it will calculate all the elements in the vector and gives you the value. I have taken the example here like sum. This is your function, right? In that you have to give your vector and it will add each and every element and it will give you the value. Next one is geometric mean. So the command which is used for geometric mean is called geo mean. We use this kind of command to solve your geometric mean. It is called as your geometric mean. What this geometric mean will do, it is a product of the element in a vector and the powers of the reciprocal number. See here, what it means, that it will calculate the elements, what are there in your vector, and it will reciprocal their powers and then we'll get answer. You may ask, you madam, how can we do this like this? But see, already we have discussed about this. We no need to do any mathematical calculations in your Scilab. If you give one single command called as geomean, it will only do all the calculations. So no need to do here particularly remember the formula for geo mean, what it will do. You just need to know which command is used for geometric mean and how we need to write the vector, and automatically it will only give the value to you. It is nothing but it will the product of the elements in the vector, it will do the calculation and it will reciprocal it powers. Next one is harmonic mean. It is called as harmonic mean. The command which we use is called as harmean, har mean we use. So this is a command which we use for harmonic mean, and it is a reciprocal of arithmetic mean. So now you may ask me what is arithmetical mean and everything. I'll just explain you in this clearly, but I'm telling you once again, need not to do or need not to remember any mathematical formulas in your Scilab, because once the command already it is a predefined thing, once you write your command and you give your vector, automatically it will display the answer. But still I'll explain you this example. See here, I have taken like 25, 38, 45 and 80 and 60, right? So what it will do, how many elements are there here? There are 5 elements are there, like 25 38 45 80 and 60, right? So these are 5 elements. So 5 divided by 1 by 25 1 by 38 1 by 45 1 by 80 and 1 by 60. So if we do that, first we have to do 1 by 25, 1 plus 35, 1 plus 45, 1 by 80, 1 plus 60 calculate. And then again we need to divide it by 5 divided by the value which we got from that. So you'll get this kind of value. But I suggest you to not to go with the mathematical deviation and everything. You just to remember what this command will do. It is nothing but the reciprocal of your arithmetic mean. Next one is called as standard deviation. So the command which we use for the standard deviation is stddev. Okay, we use this one. So why, for what purpose we use means, it is a tool used to measure the deviation token from the mean value. What it means, it will check the mean, what is the difference from your mean value. So it will check each and every differentiation, like it will check you what is the difference between your mean value, or it is used to measure the deviation token from the mean values. So same like that, again you need to give only the command, then automatically it will show you the answer. But in this case, standard deviation has been divided into two types. One is called as low standard deviation and another one is called as your standard deviation. Next one is called as variance. So what is this variance? It is the square root of standard deviation. So already we have discussed the standard deviation. Whatever the answer we are getting for the standard deviation, take any kind of example. I've taken the same example here. For this, first we have to do the standard deviation, and then whatever the answer we get from the standard deviation, we need to square root of that particular value, then we will get this value. So then you need to remember which command is used for variance and what is variance. It is nothing but the square root of standard deviation. Next one, quartile. So this is called as your quartile. What is meant by quarter? It means 4, right? Quartile is nothing but it means 4. So which number divides of your data points into 4 or less equal parts? It will divide your equation like into 4 or less than equal parts, means how you may think it of, like I said you, for this also there is a basic formula called Q3 minus Q1 by 2. First we need to find the Q1 and then we need to find out Q2. Again we have to divide and multiply, so all the things are there. I'll just give you an example. I said you now Q3 minus Q1 by 2. So Q1, how to find the Q1 means, see how many elements are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 plus 1 by 4. Why 4? Because it is quarter. So how many elements it may be? We need to calculate such kind of elements and we need to add by 1 and divide by 4 because it is quarter. So 4. So we have to divide by 4. Whatever the answer we get, that is called as your Q1. And what will be your 3? Q3 means whatever the answer we get from the Q1, we need to multiply with Q3. So suppose if I am getting answer my Q1 as 2, then I need to find out Q3 as 3 into 2, that means 6. So we need to multiply for each and everything, like 3 into 25. And whatever the value we are getting after doing this, in that way, we need to find out. Once we find out the Q1 and Q3 value, we need to divide by 2. So all this action and reaction, everything will be going on behind your application. So you just need to remember that whatever the vector if you are given, it will divide that particular data points into 4 equal parts or less than equal parts. So we got here only 3. So if not 4, 3 or 4, that much only. Next one is called as min. What is meant by min? That is called as minimum. So it is used to find the smallest element in your vector. So if your vector consists of 5 or 6 or 10 elements, anything it may be. So whatever the elements he has given in your vector, it will search for the minimum value in your vector. That is called as the find out in the smallest element in your vector, and it will give the answer to you. So the command you used for this is called for the minimum, we use min. Next one, max. Max is nothing but maximum. Maximum means what? It is used to find the largest element in the vector. So same example I have taken you here also. But in this also, it will find the, first of all, we find the least answer. Now we have to find the largest answer. So out of this, it may be of 10 or 20, any kind of elements it may be. It will choose one element as the largest element from your vector and it will produce the answer. Thank you.